We have this brand new engine in the mail from GoPowerSports.com. It's a Tillotson 212cc engine. It's not a Predator. It's not a Honda. It's a Honda clone, but it's rated for 10 horsepower out of the box. And the flywheel, the factory flywheel, is rated for 10,000 RPM. We've been wanting to get our hands on one of these for a while. You can pick one up for $179. We're going to be putting it on our Back to the Future go-kart because that engine developed a weird knocking.
So we're going to take the engine off of the Back to the Future inspired go-kart. We're going to put this engine on it, and we're going to crack open that case on that Predator 212 and see what's going on with it. I know what's going on with it. I turned the snot out of it. I know I broke the dipper off.
Nice.
Look at that.
I like that it's blue, man.
That is cool.
We need to put some oil in this engine, do a test fire, and then we can take apart that Predator, see what went wrong with it.
Can I call it?
Yeah, how many pulls, man?
Two.
Two pulls.
You need a hand holding it?
It'll be all right.
Okay.
Here we go. Let's try it. Need to loosen this guy.
Well, yeah.
I guess
if you're gonna rev it up.
It's gonna be interesting to see how it performs against a stage one Predator 212, because that puts out about 9 horsepower without the governor, with a header, jet, and air filter. So all that's left to do now is take the Predator off that chassis, put the Tillotson on with a torque converter, see how it performs, and then also see what went wrong with that Predator engine. First things first, we got a throttle. There we go. Think we're gonna have some confetti in there?
Some confetti?
Yeah.
I think it's gonna be a sparkly shower.
The chunks actually aren't as big. Oh, there are some large chunks.
Did we get many miles out of this engine?
No, I don't think so. That's the thing. I think it was on the baby seat drift trike. And then on this go-kart, and that's it. Remember, we did not have much time on that drift trike.
Dipper's not broken.
Huh.
Dipper's not broken. Well, that rod sure is messed up. Look at that.
Oh, look at that, man. Dang. That thing is wrecked, dude.
Yep.
Wow.
We can take the cap off and see what it looks like. Ooh. Look at that, the aluminum coming up.
So what do you think the cause of the problem here is?
I don't know. She was full of oil. That bolt wasn't tight, but it also wasn't backed out. So it's not, I don't think the cap was flexing cocking. I mean, we could have just gotten a bum engine. I mean, how many engines have we had? So I'm going to say 20 engines. 20 engines and 2 failures in 4 years.
Not bad.
That's not bad at all.
So for now, this engine's just going into storage. We could polish the crankshaft. We could put a new rod on it, but we're not going to do that today because we have this brand new engine to put on our Back to the Future cart.
I'm installing the 4 engine bolts here, and this Tillotson engine has the same bolt pattern as other Honda clones. So if you took a Honda clone off of your mini bike or go-kart, this will bolt right on in, I don't know, 10 minutes, maybe less than 10 minutes. It's really just the 4 bolts, the throttle, and then your chain.
We get a lot of questions about this too. How do I hook up throttle?
Well, you need a throttle cable kind of like ours. You feed the whole thing through this kind of bracket holder right here. And then you have your 10 millimeter barrel nut here that you feed the other end into.
Once you get the cable and the barrel nut, you get your buddy to press the gas and tighten it down to make sure you have both full throttle and idle.
We had to put the front half of that torque converter on our Coleman when we did the performance mods for the CT200U, so we need to grab a new torque converter. Thankfully, we just got a big shipment in the mail from Go Power Sports.
Ooh.
What is that? What is that?
We have these wheels and tires. They were originally going to go on the lawnmower, but I'm pretty happy with the ones that are already on there, so we're gonna have these hang around for a future project.
I'm gonna say sprockets.
I'm gonna say sprockets. I think you're right. Yep. Oh yeah, I got a big old sprocket. 60 tooth?
It's a steering wheel.
Oh, nice. Dude, a flat bottom steering wheel?
Flat bottom steering wheel.
What?
I gotta check this.
Yeah, we gotta put that on the mower.
Ooh.
Yo. Hey, that's cool.
I hadn't seen that before.
No, me neither. All right, so here's what we need here. New torque converter. Let's go ahead and put her on.
It's blue. It matches the engine.
It does. Dude, I had no idea they were making those. Got a belt here. And the unit itself. Ooh, this one's
black.
That's cool. It's painted.
We both really like this brand new black backing plate. It looks like it has some minor improvements over the old unit, and the black paint is a nice touch too, but we're gonna go with the old aluminum one because we already ground down that boss there to get it to fit our chassis, and the bosses on this one seem to be larger, and we just don't wanna have to ruin the paint and grind it off.
Cool.
All right. And then put the clutch,
Here we go.
All right, so we just need to tighten up the chain.
Yep.
And go for a ride?
Yep.
Sounds good, dude. See how close that torque converter comes to the engine plate?
All right, that's gonna do it.
Wheels on, focus on, here we go. There's a lawnmower over here, bud.
I don't know how they got a muffler to flow that well and be that quiet. You know, it's the same size as a Predator muffler, but it's 10 horsepower. Fire me up, please.
Yes, sir. Yeah, bud.
Don't quite lock up.
I'm gonna say 32 is more accurate.
31.4.
Okay.
That's pretty good for a governed engine and a huge sprocket.
Yeah.
Ready?
Yep.
It's the perfect setup for this yard, isn't it?
It is so fun.
You got grass down your shorts?
Maybe. And it feels so predictable.
Yeah, it's a good chassis, too.
Yeah.
Well, you want to drill some holes in those spindles?
I guess you want more drift angle, huh?
I think we should do that. And then maybe, I think we could have a competition, right? So not like the usual Cars and Cameras Grand Prix.
Okay.
But the Cars and Cameras Drift Circuit. You know what I'm saying?
And how would we judge the drift circuit?
The audience judges.
The audience judges.
Yeah.
So we drilled some holes to make the steering radius a little bit tighter, and we decided that since because this yard, or this setup is just perfect for this yard right now, we're gonna have a little bit of a twist. We're each gonna do two laps around the Grand Prix and we're gonna time it, but the main thing isn't the lowest lap time, it's the most amount of style. I am not gonna see most of the tricks that Ike does, and he's not gonna see the ones that I do, so you guys are gonna be the judges in this competition. Leave a comment down below after we both go, let you know who you thought won the competition.
I was thinking we'd go with style and how fast we go around the track.
Yep.
So taking those two into consideration, who's gonna win? Hey Mark, get set, go. Vote for me. John doesn't need to win this. So it was 11:14. I don't know why I was thinking one lap, I stopped it. But I'm thinking 10 seconds. Just add 10 seconds and it was 1:14. So basically 1:24.
That was a rough couple laps.
I bet. A little longer than I thought.
Yeah. Did you pull off the 360?
Almost.
Yeah, I didn't. I tried it too.
Really?
Yeah.
Where'd you try it?
Right over this front stretch over here.
Oh, okay. I got a little bit more speed. And, oh, you saw me, didn't you?
Yeah, I saw it.
I was close. The second time, no.
After using the Tillotson just for today, you can really tell it was designed by people that know not only go-karts and mini bikes, but performance go-karts and mini bikes. You get out-of-the-box performance, 10 horsepower, flywheel rated for 10,000 RPM, and it's the little things too, like the bolt in the end of the crankshaft. That's just one less run of the store you have to do. And the fuel cap seems to be more off to the side than on a Predator engine. So like when your engine is crammed under a mini bike, it's easier to get to the fuel cap. That's what we've seen anyway. Quiet exhaust is a nice touch too, and it still flows really well. Anyway, once again, the Tillotson 212 is available only from gopowersports.com. Check our links in the description to check them out. And don't forget about our discount code CC10 for 10% off Motes parts on their website.
So I believe next video we're gonna do on this, we're gonna put it up against the original American Express, one of my personal favorite go-karts, and see how they pair up against each other.
Leave a thumbs up if you enjoyed the video today, guys. It helps our videos get seen by more people, and subscribe if you have not already, and press the little bell to receive notifications from us. Check out our new t-shirt, Mini Mayhem, at cars-cameras.com. Don't forget to comment down below who won our little style competition, Ike or John. And another piece of big news, we finally got more hats in stock, so pick one up at cars-cameras.com. We've been getting a lot of comments about those, so pick one up now. And also, we're going to announce another date in October for Busco Beach soon. So stay tuned for that. We got a lot of exciting things going on, guys. Really appreciate your support. 500,000 subscribers a little while ago. We're just going to keep on trucking. We appreciate your support. Thumbs up, subscribe. We'll see you next time. Other piece of news, guys. The other day was Ike's birthday, so we're eating cake in the garage.
What's your favorite kind of cake, man?
Carrot cake.
Is it really your favorite?
Yep.
Oh, dude, I nailed it.
Yeah, you did.